Hi and welcome to the channel. Today we will unbox, mount, and test this Thermalright Silversoul 135 Black, also known as SS135. Specs wise, the important part is the height, which is 135 mm. It has 6 6mm heat pipes and the number of fins. It also has 6 years warranty. At the other side of the box, there's a specification for the fan, which is the D12 Pro. It's basically a 120 mm fan. So I bought this from PC Cools or Cooles. Anyway, it's from China and it was for around 3,625 pesos, which is roughly the same as what I could find locally. However, this has LGA 17XX support, which is for 12th gen and 13th gen Intel processors. Opening the box. So to open it, it's like this. And then you have to rotate like this. So it is padded by medium thickness foam. Immediately we'll see an LGA 17XX bracket. I'm just assuming it. So yes, this is an LGA 17XX bracket. I need this because I will use it for my next build. So this is the fan, the D12 Pro. Looks good. It has pre-installed the anti-vibration pads. And this is the manual in Chinese. Okay, there's an English translation at the back. So let's going to keep this because I need this. However, there's a bracket for LGA 17XX, but there's no specific entry in the manual. Oh, sorry. I found the LGA 17XX manual. I have to keep this as well. Then this is probably a warranty card. Accessories package. Let's open it. So we have the 115X backplate, some nuts and bolts, fan clips, then probably for mounting and thermal paste. It also has a fan splitter, which is good. So this is the heat sink itself. I like this heat sink as the edges are smooth. They're very smooth. So I will probably not be wounded by this heat sink. So I have a heat sink before that has given me probably 3 to 5 wounds already. This looks nice and the finishing is also nice. Okay, nothing more. Thermal paste. So the bracket has label for EM4, which is nice. So based on the manual, the EM4 screw is a bit longer. So this is the standoff. These are the EM4 screws. So I need this. As for the rest, I suggest to keep it in a resealable pouch. So for example, I have this LGA 115X backplate. I suggest to keep it here since this is resealable. Okay, as for the motherboard, this is an ASUS Tough Gaming B550M Zaku. And as for the processor, this is an AMD Ryzen 7 5800X. The backplate is already here. I have to put standoffs first. So I think it's supposed to be this way. Since if you look at the other side, it will not reach the other ends. So for that, I have to reach it from the back. So first comment is that you cannot screw this standoff to the backplate, so it's very loose. Use your hands to initially screw it first, not to tighten but to just grip the backplate. We will use a screwdriver later. The reason for this is that I'm just using one hand to hold everything together and may not be able to use a screwdriver in this position while my other hand is holding the backplate. And then now we can use a screwdriver to tighten. Then it seems that we can mount this like this. This is a weird screw. Yeah, it looks weird. Oh, I forgot to peel. Then apply the thermal paste. Yes, it's a gluey paste. Then mount it like this. Align the screws. Then you can screw it now. So I think it's tight enough. I can lift the whole thing using the heatsink. Anyway, sorry for the out of focus, but it looks okay. Then just have to mount the fans. As for the fans, there's some, I would call them railings here, which I could clip the fan to the heatsink. They also gave 4 clips, but you only have 1 fan, so I actually just need 2. So you can buy another fan to mount it, probably here, an exhaust here, or yeah, it should be an exhaust here. So it seems that you should have put it like this. Then what's remaining is the fan head. Okay, looks nice. Mounting wise, I'm very happy with this cooler. It's time to test it. As for the benchmarks while running Cinebench R23, the SS135 was 90 degrees Celsius with its stock fan. However, the stock fan was too loud such that it could be heard 6 meters away from the machine. And so I replaced it with a Noctua fan. It became quiet but it did not improve the thermal performance. I also added another 120mm fan at the back but still, it did not significantly improve the thermal performance. I tried to benchmark FF15 and it averaged 71.3 degrees Celsius with its loud stock fan and averaged at 73.7 degrees Celsius with a single Noctua fan and averaged 72.4 degrees Celsius with 2 Noctua fans. Do note, however, that the ambient temperature was not controlled, so the difference might simply be due to ambient temps change, as my testing with stock fan was during early morning and with Noctua fans during a sunny afternoon. Overall, this performs roughly the same as the Arctic Freezer Esports 34 Duo. As for its pros and cons against Arctic Freezer 34 Esports Duo, Arctic's offering is cheaper and at stock is more quiet than Thermalright. Thermalright is also more expensive by 1,000 pesos or around $85. For me, both were easy enough to mount, but one thing that I like about Thermalright SS135 is its aesthetics and finishing. Arctic Freezer 34 has very sharp fin stocks that I've been wounded by this cooler for around 3 to 5 times already. The SS135 has a very smooth fin stock. The fan installation is also easier as clips are softer and don't require brute force. SS135's height is also smaller at 135mm, which may be a good fit for SFF cases at 15 to 20 liters, where the Arctic Freezer 34 will likely not fit. As for overall recommendations, if your case can fit the Arctic Freezer 34 Esports, then I'd go for it. It's cheap, quiet, and can do the job. Otherwise, if you are not particular with the noise, I'm fine with this cooler, and this will be used in my next SFF build. If you are looking for an alternative, do check out ID Cooling SE207XT Slim. It's cheaper locally if at stock and may perform similar to this cooler. Okay, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. Do like or dislike, comment on what you think, and subscribe for more unboxing and benchmarks. Bye!